looking for someone who was sold to you. A half-breed banished from our land.
Why did you come for me?
Those who enslaved you have taken over our land.
Mountains of corpses will not stand in our way.
We believe you are the only one who can help us.
Their army is infinite.
We are 47.
If we do this, there's no coming back.
The enemy will be watching.
I know what you are.
You have no idea.
I'm not afraid of you.
You should be.
Life belongs to
us. Then take it if you can.
Come on.
Will I see this movie? Definitely. Will it be deeply flawed? Probably. I mean, it's just kind of the feeling I get from the trailer. It looks like it's short on story and also cheap for some reason. I mean, obviously they spent a lot of money, it has a lot of special effects, but there's just something about the picture quality and the composition of the frames that screams more Hansel and Gretel Witch Hunters than The Matrix, which is unfortunate. This is something Hollywood's been doing a lot lately. They hire a first-time director and they throw them in the deep end. And I've heard studio heads defend it saying, trial by fire, they have to learn sometime. And I was also talking to someone the other day, you know, one of the editors who works on this show, and he pointed out that when they bring in these new directors, they're easier to control because they don't have a track record to back them up. So a studio can say, hey, we want you to do XYZ, and the director's just so happy to have their first big gig that they're like, okay. But I don't know if the result here is, what the end result here is, if it's going to be because of studio meddling, or it's going to be from script problems, or from an inexperienced director. It could be all of them. But so why did I say I was definitely going to go? Because I'm just a sucker for this kind of movie. I'm just a sucker for this kind of storytelling. Who doesn't want to see Keanu Reeves return back to the big screen? I think that as an actor, he always chooses somewhat interesting projects. So I'm going to trust his decision a little bit here. You know, his vote of faith in the film earns a vote of faith from me. And I'm just also really interested in Asian culture. Also, that's another issue about this trailer. Some people have been saying that it's offensive because, you know, it's taking an Asian fairy tale, Asian mythology, and, you know, the Western world is, you know, twisting it. But I would say, I mean, as you can see, there's a largely Asian cast here, which is great. Keanu Reeves is playing, they said, a half-breed. So, you know, they're justifying the fact that he's not, that he is, you know, I believe Keanu Reeves is like half Hawaiian, but, you know, they're justifying his casting. And also, look at what's being done to European fairy tales in Hollywood right now. I mean, you have Alice in Wonderland, Tim Burton famously twisted, then Snow White and the Huntsman was also somewhat successful, a similar choice, and Disney's right now doing a Dark Cinderella. So why not turn it to other fairy tales from around the world? I actually think I like it. I think it's refreshing, and it's just more of the global Hollywood we're beginning to see emerge. Also, the other reason I, of course, am worried about this movie is because it's been held in development and post-production just for so long. I mean, it's been shot a long time ago. They keep pushing it. It's finally coming out for Christmas. So I will go and see it. Will I be able to talk anyone to going with me? I don't know. That might be a taller order. Because I think that a lot of regular mainstream audience moviegoers, you know, they don't have as much faith in Keanu Reeves and, you know, Asian films and Asian genre stuff as I think someone like you and I do. So that's my thoughts on 47 Ronin. I don't have much hope, but I have faith. So Keanu has his fan base, and we'll see how it turns out. Hopefully I'll be rewarded. Well, what do you think? Write your thoughts down below. Do you think 47 Ronin is offensive, or do you think that's just part of the new global Hollywood, as I've said? And also, what other, you know, what other non-European fairy tales do you think might make a good movie? Write your thoughts down below, and as always, thank you for coming to be on the trailer for the latest trailers, followed by these snapshot reviews. More coming in Trailer Review Palooza right now.